gentlemen, at 6 o'clock, the council members will take their seat. We can begin. At this point, I see a quorum of council on the dais. Therefore, I'll call this meeting to order. I'd ask at this point we stand for the invocation to be given by John Westbrook of Fifth Street Baptist, and afterwards the Pledge of Allegiance.
Let us pray. To our God, creator of the universe and sustainer of all that is within, we invite your presence into this, the people's chamber, and among us, the governing body of the city of Richmond, Virginia. We pray that you would endow us with your spirit and grant us a wee bit of your wisdom, such that we can be diligent in our deliberations, compassionate in our considerations, and dutiful in our decisions. Keep us mindful that we are stewards of the people's assets and not ours, and that we are held accountable for the well-being of the citizens of Richmond, Virginia. May our actions be in accordance with your perfect will. Please hear and answer our prayer, and may the words of our mouths and the meditations of our hearts be acceptable in your sight. Amen.
Amen. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you very much. You may be seated. Mr. Clerk, at this point, would you please give the emergency evacuation?
Yes, Mr. President. Before I do that, I believe all of the members are present. Mr. Clowes, accept Mr. Clowes. Okay. Next we'll have,
thank you, Mr. Clark. Actually, we're going to do something a little bit different tonight. We have some regional visitors with us that I would like to introduce. John Vithoulkas, the county manager from Henrico County, and some of his staff are here. Maybe you'd like to bring everybody.
Mr. President, Madam Vice President, members of the council, Mr. Marshall. I was in a meeting with Mr. Marshall earlier today, and I've got County Attorney Joe Fasardo with me, County Attorney Risa South, and Deputy County Manager Tim Foster. We were meeting on an issue of mutual concern, and President asked me to stop by and make a few comments and say hello, and I think it is entirely appropriate that I do that. Local government is where the rubber meets the road. I wish you the best on your deliberations, especially the budget deliberations that you will be undergoing very shortly. I do think taking the opportunity to say hello every so often is important, and especially for me personally. I doubt many of you know this, but years ago I had the opportunity to intern with your budget office when we had a city manager by the name of Robert Bob. So every time I come into this building, I feel like I'm coming home. So thank you for the opportunity to offer you a few comments. I wish you luck in your deliberations tonight, and especially with your budget discussions in the months to come.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for taking the time to come back and say hello. When we talk about regionalism in practice, this result is to hit the nail on the head. It requires getting together and talking in order to get things done for all of our constituents. Mr. Clerk, at this point, may we please determine if all members are accounted for?
Yes, all members are present.
Thank you.
Now we're going to have the council evacuation announcement. On activation of the emergency alarm signal, all persons should immediately exit the building. Please use the exits to the left or right front of the council chambers, while the east or west stairways outside the rear doors of the chamber. Do not use the elevator or the escalators. After exiting the building, proceed to the assembly area located in the parking lot bordered by Clay, 8th and 9th Street. Citizens and employees to assist visually and hearing impaired visitors with exiting the building. Next, I'll read to you the citizens' request to sign up to speak on citizen comment period, some of the rules and guidelines. Citizen comment. Citizen comment period is an opportunity for persons to present comments and information to council not pertaining to any item on the meeting agenda for that evening. Persons wishing to address council during the citizen comment period are generally allowed 3 minutes to speak. Persons appearing before council are not allowed to campaign for public office, promote private business ventures, use language of a personal nature which insults or demeans any person, including comments directed at public officials or staff members that are not related to their official duties, or address or question staff members directly. All questions are being directed to the president of the council. Failure to adhere to the guidelines may result in speakers forfeiting any remaining time and further disciplinary actions as necessary, which could include barring from attendance of future meetings of the city council for a period of 6 months.
Thank you very much, Mr. Clerk. At this point, are there any actions on appointments or reappointments?
Yes. We have one appointment. That's resolution number 2013-R19. Ms. Carol Murray, please stand. Ms. Murray is a member of the King City Commission. Is being appointed to the member of the King City Commission for a term commencing upon adoption of this resolution and terminating January the 28th, 2015.
Thank you very much. Any other reappointments?
No, that's it.
Thank you very much. After the vote is taken on the appointment, if you would please step out to the clerk's office where you will have your oath taken. But you don't have to go until after the vote. If you just sit tight until after we vote, then you can go and have your own statement. Thank you.
Okay, council is now voting on tonight's appointment. Ms. Wells?
Aye.
Ms. Graziano?
Aye.
Ms. Mosby?
Aye.
Vice President Robertson?
She stepped away.
She stepped away for a moment. Mr. Alessio?
Aye.
Mr. Hill?
Aye.
Ms. Trammell?
Aye.
Ms. Newville?
Aye.
Mr. Clerk, before you go any further, the attorney across that session, we need to have a public hearing on this matter. Is there anyone from the audience willing to speak in favor or opposition? Seeing none, please retake the vote, Mr. Clerk.
Okay, we will now take a vote on the appointment. I'll call the names. Mr. Bowles?
Aye.
Ms. Graziano?
Aye.
Ms. Mosby?
Aye.
Ms. Robertson?
Aye.
Mr. Appalachia?
Aye.
Mr. Hilton?
Aye.
Ms. Trammell?
Aye.
Ms. Newville?
Aye.
President Sam.
Mr. Murray, thank you so much for bearing with us during some technical difficulties there. You can step out to the clerk's office for the administrative view. Thank you for your service.
Okay, next on the agenda,